I'm Alexis.
And I'm Melissa.
And you're tuned in to the AM Show.
Today, we are doing a gluten haul. I think in the past videos, you've heard us talk about my recent gluten allergy that Alexis doesn't believe in.
Not true. I'm just not as enthusiastic as Melissa is about it. And also, I don't have a gluten allergy, so...
Well, today I'm gonna make her taste test some of this delicious gluten food.
And you will also get to see what you might like. So, stay tuned. We have
a blueberry muffin that was purchased from Price Chopper, and it's by Udis, and Udis is a very popular brand. Like, they make breads and all types of stuff. So
I love muffins.
Eat up. I actually particularly think they're better warmed up, but we'll see what she says.
Here we go.
It's delicious.
You know, it actually is.
Ew, don't talk with your mouth full.
It's a little dry, but muffins are usually...
Nothing a glass of milk can't fix.
This is good, though.
Like, sometimes when you're just eating, like, healthier foods, it could taste different. So does it, like, taste different at all?
This is good, but I love sweets, so that might also be... a factor.
Anyway, comes
five
in
stars.
Comes in a pack of four, and I mean, diet stuff, healthy items get pretty pricey, so I want to say I paid maybe like $4.95 for these. And they're nice size.
Worth it. Worth it.
Perfect. Next, we are going to try fully loaded caramel popcorn.
Ooh.
Now, I have never had this, so we'll see what it tastes like. It is by Open Road Snacks. Never heard of them.
She gave me like two pieces.
'Cause she's wasteful.
Okay. Sweet.
Tastes like regular like caramel popcorn. Like, you know, at Christmas time when you get the Christmas cans and it comes with the three, like, yeah, the regular, the cheddar, and the caramel.
Yep.
That's what it tastes like. So perfect for the movies. You gotta take it with you.
And this is how much?
So for the popcorn, I believe I paid close to about like $3. These also come from Price Chopper.
Price Chopper has a whole gluten-free section.
And freezer section.
Wow. I didn't know that.
That's where I found the muffins.
Really?
In the freezer section, yeah. So, keep them cold. Yeah.
I'm still eating this muffin. The muffins is really good.
Like, I'm just gonna go ahead and dig into the popcorn some more. So, you recommend the muffins. That's one.
I do recommend the popcorn as well.
Gluten-free is winning right now.
I'm still not 100% convinced, so.
I'm gonna convert her, guys. Gluten on it, gluten diet.
Gluten.
Okay.
I'm like, move on, what's in here eating?
Okay, we get it, y'all like
no, 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 no.
See how fast we can eat. Okay, so this isn't particularly gluten-free. I mean, I looked at the ingredients. It's a Herdez guacamole salsa. And I looked at the ingredients and there's nothing in here telling me it ain't gluten-free. So, and then
living on the deep end.
Oh, what can I say? I like to live on the edge, okay?
That's what I meant to say. I don't know what the heck deep end is.
Okay, so to go with this guacamole salsa, we have Santa Fe restaurant style tortilla chips. Gluten free.
Yeah.
So it says. All right. Sorry, yes, the bag was already open.
She clearly likes it. The bag is almost gone.
It actually is really good.
She gave me two chips.
I don't want your tummy to hurt. So I thought the guac was a little...
runny.
Spicy.
I like thick guac. This is a little...
Well, it says authentic. All the stuff you've been eating is probably fake. Okay.
Whoa. This is good.
So wait, you can't comment on them at the same time. It has to be the tortilla chips, and then you have to comment on the salsa.
Oh. Yeah, the chips pretty much just taste like regular tortilla chips.
Okay.
The salsa, I mean the guac, is not salsa.
Guacamole salsa.
No. It's spicy.
And it's medium. I got it in medium. I didn't see any mild and I didn't see any super hot either.
It's spicy.
$2.75 for the chips from Price Chopper, and the Herdez salsa is from Walmart. Can't really remember what I paid. We'll insert it at the bottom or something. So, is it 3 for 3?
3 for 3, definitely. I'm really feeling the tortilla chips, and I love me a good guac. The guac is a little bit spicy. I don't like spicy food, but 5 stars.
So a lot of people, like, you don't even have to, you know, of course you don't have to be gluten-free to eat gluten-free stuff, but a lot of people have cut it out their diets because it helps with, like, do you ever eat and you just feel so bloated, like, after a burger?
Yes.
That gluten, it, like, takes out all that bad stuff that makes you feel bloated. So it is your wheats, your soys, your flours, things like that.
Yes. Yeah.
A lot of your carby stuff. Oh, yeah.
Cereal,
my favorite. So all Cheerios, so I have just recently found out, are all gluten free.
Wow.
Yeah, and they come in so many different flavors. The regular Cheerios, the Honey Nut Cheerios. Now they got Berry Berry Cheerios. And last week I just had Blueberry Cheerios.
Wow, they really come in that many flavors though? I didn't know that.
Yes.
I always thought Cheerios were kind of bland.
The regular Cheerios, not Honey Nut.
I don't know.
Honey Nut is the regular Cheerios. Yeah, anything sweet.
I'm a big sweet eater.
Clearly.
Cheerios are really good.
Can't go wrong with Cheerios.
Yeah, they are.
What type of milk do you drink?
I like almond milk.
Really?
Almond milk is really good.
Do you like almonds?
Yeah.
Hmm.
Yeah. I mean, why not? These Cheerios. 5. Yeah, we do have a lot of snacks. This is snack food. Well, snack haul. Well, snack gluten haul.
Breakfast haul. Besides the popcorn.
And the chips and salsa.
Bagels. We got bagels coming up next, guys.
The debate.
So, muffin.
Bagel is it?
So it is a Canon Bakehouse bagel, 100% whole grain. I got these from Walmart. Walmart too has a gluten-free aisle. I'm not for sure if they have a freezer section though. Paid about $3.50, $4.
Smells good. What do you usually put on it?
Put anything, butter, jelly, I use butter and jelly. And I don't just eat it like that. I always toast mine. I've never tried these though.
They're good. What flavor is it?
Herbs, whole grain.
This is obviously not just whole grain.
Do you see anything else on here? Ew. I don't particularly like it.
Ew. Okay, last but certainly not least, we have
some pancakes. But it's more than pancakes. They can also be muffins.
Mmm.
So this brand is Live G Free, Live Gluten Free. And it's pancake and baking mix. You can make pancakes, waffles, biscuits, and muffins. And this is an Aldi's brand, guys. Aldi's brand.
Aldi.
They don't have like an aisle, but they have like a little end rack, little kiosk. So they're working on it.
Smells good.
We also have, you can't have pancakes without syrup.
Right.
So we got this Carrie's sugar-free, low-calorie syrup that is gluten. See that?
Gluten-free.
I got this from Price Chopper.
Okay.
So, eat up, sport. I've already tried these for breakfast.
Let's dig in.
Perfect. She's not being wasteful. See what you think.
I don't particularly like the pancakes.
I'm glad we're on the same page. I was like, I don't know if I'll ever make these for breakfast again. They don't. I mean, like, of course, they kind of taste like a pancake, but
they're really bland.
Very.
They taste like
ew. Yeah. Yeah.
They taste like sawdust.
I feel like a lot of the bready foods do, so I'm kind of surprised that the bagel and the muffin don't.
This isn't good at all.
Well, what about the syrup, though?
The syrup is sweet. You can't go wrong with a good syrup.
That's crazy because it says sugar-free, so I wouldn't think it'd be that sweet.
It's not. Maybe it's just the pancake is so dull that the syrup is just...
Looking for anything to make it taste good.
The pancake is so dull that the syrup is just outrageously good. I don't know, but it's...
Yeah.
Yeah.
Wasn't my favorite either, pal.
So, if you like this gluten-free haul, don't forget to subscribe and like and comment below on what other gluten-free products you want to see, right?
Right. Or even if you want to see us do something different, like dairy-free.
I'm down for it.
See ya.